What's up, y'all? I'm here in Harlem, actually doing a bit of apartment searching, which got me thinking. I'm sure there are a few of you guys who are trying to look to move somewhere else, but are wondering how to get the best deals. Well, I called up Cash Jordan to give us some tips. Let's check it out.
Everyone is looking for apartments, it feels like, in my friend's group, and I've gotten sucked in, which is, again, mm-hmm. I'm so stoked that we're speaking because Cash Jordan, listen. If there's anyone to talk to about all this, it is you. Let me know what the feedback's been like, you know, on your TikTok page, your channel, and, you know, just as a broker and what your business has been like this year.
Sure. So this all kind of came out of the new reality that we're dealing with, right? Like, everything's supposed to go online and be virtual. Well, there's not really a better way to do that than to use TikTok and YouTube to put the product out there so that people can see it. And the crazy thing is, right after the lockdown started, there were people who contacted my office and said, listen, we're in California right now. We're waiting this whole thing out. And this is April. This was when everybody was really frightened and when no one was doing anything, no one was showing apartments. And they were like, listen, we saw your YouTube video where you've got the dimensions of the apartment, the neighborhood presentation, and you've shown everything. We're just going to take that apartment. So that was a really eye-opening moment right there, to think that a 10-minute video on YouTube and even shorter videos than that on TikTok could generate enough buzz to help people feel comfortable with a pretty big decision. I mean, renting's a huge decision.
I want to maybe debunk a pandemic searching for an apartment myth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Can I actually get a good deal right now?
A month ago, statistics came out that showed that there were over 13,000 empty apartments in Manhattan. And that's an all-time record. And because that's an all-time record and landlords don't know what to do, they're giving concessions that they weren't giving before. There are property owners that I work with who in years past didn't offer any concession, didn't offer any free rent, and made me collect my commission from the renter, who are now paying me my commission and giving away 2 months of free rent, which is happening at a lower price than last year's rent. So absolutely, deals are out there. I don't know if the rent will ever be low enough for everyone because, again, it's a super expensive thing. But yeah, if you compare the rent you're going to pay in 2020 to the 2019 rent and you include all the concessions that you're going to get, you're probably going to see a lower price. If you're not, I would continue doing your research.
Is right now a good time to even be moving in New York City or out of New York City for that matter?
So this might not be the answer you're expecting, but my ultimate belief is that the apartment supports a greater purpose, right? I mean, it's cool to have your own apartment, but since you're renting, at the end of your stay in that apartment, you'll have spent the money on rent and hopefully you'll have accomplished whatever it is that you took the apartment to do, to work at a new job, to maybe get further along in school, to finish a degree or a program somewhere. So I think that if you have a need for the apartment, and you need to be here right now, your first year in New York, which is usually the hardest, is going to be the easiest for you because rents are lower than they've been in quite some time.
Dope. Okay, so what about those of us who are already here? Mm-hmm. Like,
okay,
we've already got a place to stay, we're already in an apartment, but you know what they say, grass is greener, rents are falling.
Yeah.
Like, is that a chance we should even be considering or taking?
So I think it depends. It's going to be a tough answer to apply to everybody because, you know, if you're in a part of town now, which has different rental dynamics than, let's say, the West Village, which is really taking a hit, or the East Village, rather, which is really taking a hit, the answer might be a little bit different. But what I think everyone should do, no matter where they live, is to go online and do your research. You know, whatever type of apartment you're in right now, go on websites that list apartments. And you can see virtual tours. If you see my listings, you can see video tours on my YouTube channel. Get as much information as you can, which is actually pretty easy. You don't even have to leave the house. And that'll tell you what you're paying right now. If you're paying right now is above what you can get, that's a conversation you can have with your landlord or a conversation you can have with a new landlord because you found a new place. The one piece of advice that I would give is to check. Some sites like StreetEasy will have the past rental history of a unit. And one thing that you might want to do is just look at what the rent was like previously, because if there was to be a robust recovery in New York City within a year or two, things could start to creep back up. And that might give you a little bit of insight as to what rent could be. But by all accounts, no one thinks that within the next, you know, 5 minutes, things will change back. So.
All right. Now I want to get into the nitty gritty of some do's and don'ts. I know you've most recently done a really great video that actually like tackles some of these, but you know, for folks who are wondering, you know, I should do this, I shouldn't do this.
What you don't want to do is take the first thing that you see in person. You know, you might do a ton of online research and you might select like one or two places that you really like, and then you might finally go and see those in person. And then you might say, okay, this is the one. But you want to be careful, because even though you've seen a lot that's online, you haven't seen a lot in person. And until you're physically in the apartment, you walk down the street, you walk into the building, you walk into the apartment, you see it, you smell it, you hear it, you know, until you've done that, you haven't really compared multiple places. So I think that, you know, no matter what you find online, make sure you look at as many as you can in person. That way you get the whole picture. You can see what the building's like, because a lot of stuff isn't really shown to you. You know, you see some nice pictures, you see a nice floor plan. That's not indicative necessarily of how well the building's cared for. I'll just mention one more that I think is huge that people should really keep in mind. It's that the less time that you have to make a decision, the worse your decision might be in this rental market. Because if you feel like you're pressured to pick a place because you're moving here in 3 days, you're not gonna decide on your next apartment the same way you would that if you had 3 weeks or 3 months of lead time to find something. You know, the more time you can give yourself in this market, the better you're gonna do and the happier you're gonna be with the end result, because you're not gonna have any renter's regret. You know, you're not gonna move in and then check online the day that you set up your internet and be like, oh man, I took the wrong place, or I'm in the wrong place. Like, nobody wants to feel that way. So the more time you can give yourself before it's decision time, the better off you're gonna be.